And I'm going to start at the 25th verse. This is the Lord speaking. He said, I am he that blotteth out thy transgression for my own sake, and will not remember thy sins. I may be justified. I'll read that one more time. Put me in remembrance. Let us plead together. Declare thou that thou mayest be justified. Quickly to the first epistle of John, the 5th chapter, 14 and 15 verses. I have a lesson I want to share tonight, but I got a check in my spirit. I didn't feel that the timing was right. And I started saying in my spirit to the Lord, that I could almost hear people saying, how? So we're going to talk tonight about how. 5th chapter, 1 John, and 14 and 15 verse. And this is the confidence that we have in him, in God, that if we ask anything according to his will, he hear us. Then he goes on to say, if we know that he hear us, it is good now. If we know that he hear us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have. Is that it? Mm-hmm. Did you get it?
Man.
If we know that he hear us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Lord.
I'm going to go ahead and finish reading. And if we know that he hear us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we receive of, we have the petition that we desire of him. So, whatever we ask, we know we have what we desire of him. Mm. Why? Because we ask according to his will. Mm. Therefore, he always hears us.
Thank you, Lord.
So the best thing to do is to ask according to his will, mm-hmm. so you know you heard. Amen?
Amen.
Well, people, how do you know what God's will is? Somebody say, his word.
Thank you, Lord.
Word.
We just read you out of Isaiah, what is the chapter, that 26th verse. He said, put me in remembrance mm-hmm. and declare thou that you may be justified. You know, one of the things that people don't understand is that God wants you to reason with him.
Lord.
Amen. God is a covenant God. Somebody say covenant God.
Covenant God.
Not a contract God, a covenant God. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So God made a covenant with Abraham. First one, other than the one he made with Noah. God made a covenant with Abraham and sealed it with man's blood. And then, with Jesus of Nazareth, sealed it with God's blood. Amen.
Amen.
So that agreement, that covenant, cannot be broken. It has finally been sealed 2,000 years ago by the blood of Christ. Mm-hmm. So now, God is obligated.
Thank you, Lord.
To those that have covenant with him
mm.
to honor the promises that he made in the covenant mm. to them. Mm-mm-mm. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Now, someone may say, well, Pastor, well, God can do anything. Yes, he can. But he will not override your free will.
Thank you.
So you and I must believe what he said in the covenant. Belongs to us.
Man.
If we don't believe it belongs to us, then it won't. So, God said, I think, with 2 Corinthians 1:14, somewhere over there, all God promises in Jesus, might be 20, all God promises in Jesus are what? Yay. Yay. Somebody say yay.
Yay.
That's King James. And it actually means yes. And you know, we say, yes, somebody asks you a question, you say, yes, what does that mean? Yeah. So if somebody did that, that'd be right. Amen? Amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
So once we say yes, that means we're compliable.
Amen.
So when God said, that is the 20th verse, when God said for all the promises, all his promises in Christ are yea and amen.
Thank
so if you're in Christ, all the promises are not maybe wait one day. It's yes.
Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
It's yes.
Yes.
It's yes. So all we have to do is find out what belongs to us in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And when we pray, put me in remembrance.
That's right.
Isaiah 43 and 26. And when we pray, 1 John 5, 14, if we know that he hear us, hello somebody.
Thank you, Lord.
And we already said, this is the comfort that we have in him. We ask anything for him, will he
hear
us? So his will is his promise. So once you pray the promise, you know what? He hears you.
Hallelujah.
So if we're going to be overcomers, if we are going to qualify ourselves to be accounted worthy to escape, it's time out for playing those church religious games.
Thank you.
This is not shooting in the dark till you hit something.
Lord.
The work has already been finished. Jesus on the cross cried back, it is
finished.
Wait a minute, let's pray. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you for the spirit of wisdom. I thank you for the spirit of revelation and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Thank you for coming upon your people. Thank you for illuminating their understanding. Thank you for giving me the specific word to speak to them at this specific time that their faith will rest in you and your faithfulness. Thank you for empowering and impart some spiritual blessing, some spiritual gift, some spiritual grace unto them, that they may be equipped to fulfill your will and purpose in their life. I thank you, I pray that the adversary defeated and power and broken and destroyed, have no place, no father out in his house. Thank you that anyone that may have been suffering with an attack from him, it ends now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
The angels of God will usher in and encamp round about them and deliver them.
Thank you
for anointing me. Thank you for empowering me. Thank you for using me for your glory and your honor and your praise. Everyone said in Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So all God promises in Jesus are yes and amen.
Mm-hmm.
So that means all we need to do is find out what the promises of God are. And pray accordingly.
Lord.
And then according to 1 John 5 and 14, hello somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Our confidence is that if we ask anything for us, will he hear us?
Mm-hmm.
So you can have confidence. You can have assurance that God hears you when you pray according to his will.
Amen.
His will is what he said.
Amen.
He said, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return to me void, but it will accomplish that in which I please and prosper the thing willing to I sin in. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
So God will do what he said. Somebody say, God will do what he said. Now, I want you to understand, and I want you to get this in your lower. I want somehow to pack it down in there, get it down in there some kind of way. But I want it in there where it won't be moved, won't be shaken, won't ever come back out. I want you to get this. No one can stop God from hearing you but you.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
And it's slowed down. Maybe they get it better this time. No one can stop God from hearing you but you.
You.
Thank you.
So what I'm saying to you, if your prayers are not being answered, then nobody has a fault but
you.
Yours. God delights in answering his children. The scripture actually says, and I'm on 2 Chronicles 16 and 9, and 1 Chronicles 16 and 9. For the eyes of the Lord run to and fro throughout the whole earth, seeking to show himself strong in the behalf of those whose heart is perfect toward him.
Amen.
Amen. And so, and you know, I've often wondered how people are so quick. I'm talking to the church now. I'm not talking to sinners. If you're a sinner, you might not have ever experienced this or seen this. But in the church, we've seen, church folk have seen things that cannot be explained.
Mm-hmm.
Miracles. Happenings, things going on that can't be explained with natural reason. So they had to accept it as being the hand of God.
Mm-hmm.
But then they're so quick when they leave out the church and walk away from that experience to forget what they just saw, what they just experienced, or what they just heard God say or do. By experience themselves. So what happened? It is spiritual. The natural minded person cannot receive the things of God.
Amen.
Are you talking? Because they're spiritually discerned. And they're foolish to that natural minded person. People that only think about the flesh. And what did I say the full drive of the human flesh, of the flesh is? The animal, beast, is?
David.
Hello? To protect his body with his sheltered clothing, right? To defend itself is under attack, which is self-preservation. Then that fourth is procreation, which curtails having sex. So if a person's life does not exist, their whole world revolves around eating, making sure their body is protected, and defending themselves against those that come against them, whether it be in speech or in action, and having sex.
That's it.
They're no more than a dog, a cat, a cow, a horse, or whatever. Are y'all following what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And so, therefore, they're easily herded by life circumstances.
Yep.
Instead of them acting, they're always reacting. So whatever's going on, they never take a purposeful, mindful, pre-planned thought to act toward this thing. They just react to that thing.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Just like an animal. So, a certain cattleman went out one day, and his cattle seemed to be a little sickly. Some of them were doing pretty good, but a few of them was a little sickly. So he decided that he was going to get this veterinarian to come check them out. So the veterinarian came and checked them out and said, I got this medicine I want to give them, and I think they'll do better. And as they do better, that'll protect the rest of them. So the veterinarian mixed up his little concoction and gave it to the sickly ones, or the ones that thought they were going to be sick. Are y'all here? And they all took it, but then they started to act like something was wrong with it. Are you here? Are you here?
Amen.
So the cattleman went out there and checked them out. And he just happened to have, are you here?
Amen.
A metal horn in his hand.
Mm-hmm.
And it snatched out his hand and stuck to the cattle.
Wow.
And he said, what is this? So he goes back and he checks with the veterinarian. The veterinarian said, I put some metal magnetic grain in there so that it would pull out the poison out the system. So it wouldn't circulate and they'll be okay. And that's what caught your little cold. Y'all hear me, you go home. Now the cattle being numbered cattle, they don't know no better.
Well,
all they know, they're just getting around a little wobbly, not quite as good as they used to get around. But, you know, you understand what I'm saying?
Pretty good.
Because their whole life was revolving around eating, protection, hello, somebody, fighting against those that fight against them, and having sex and reproducing more cattle. They didn't realize what was taking place.
Wow.
Are your father?
Lord.
And that's what's happening with a lot of people today. And they're not becoming proactive in their life and in their future. They allow circumstances.
Mm-hmm.
And the herd, Calvin, to direct them in the way that he would have them to go. Mm-hmm. And trusting him to take care of their welfare. And the sad part about it, Calvin trusted the wrong people.
Amen.
And they poison, because let me say it to you, metal is toxic to your body.
Thank you.
Hello. So now, saints, we got to come to the realization that nobody's going to do this for us. It's an individual thing.
Mm-hmm.
You got to choose to accept what God says about you.
Amen.
And apply it to your life, or it won't work. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me?
Amen.
You are the one that must qualify. Are you hearing me? By first of all, bowing your knee to the Lordship of Jesus Christ if you hadn't already done it. And surrender your life to Him for real and not religiously. Take up your cross and follow His way of life.
Glory.
And once you do that, then you become what we call an heir of God. So whatever God has, you are in line to receive it. Are you following? Are you following?
Thank you.
So at that point, God takes by His Spirit you and puts you in what we would call the I can't think of the word right now, but metaphysical body of the Lord Jesus Christ. So now, even though Yeshua, Jesus in heaven, bodily, every person that would bow their knee to the Lordship of Jesus Christ and surrender their life and begin to follow Him, the Father, the Creator, by the Spirit of God, placed him, and I'm going to call it again, I'm just using that terminology, it may not be right, but you disagree if you want to, I'm just trying to use a symbolic word, placed him in the metaphysical body of Christ. So spiritually speaking, they are now in Christ.
Mm-hmm.
And all God promises are not maybe, one day, possibly. All God promises in Christ are yes, yes, yes. But that individual must choose to deny himself. I don't know how we miss this. I don't know how preachers let folks stumble over instead of explaining it enough. I get there too busy trying to make people excited and thrilled and jumping up and down and they go, you really preach. You ain't really preaching, your people dying. Spiritually. You ain't preach or preaching to preach. God said it foolish and pleased him rather by the foolishness of preaching. I got my word with them. And please God by the foolishness of preaching to save men. Save them. That means not just make them happy and thrilled.
Lord.
But the same thing.
Thank you.
It pleased him by the foolishness of preaching to save man. So God uses the preaching of the word to get people right with him and deliver. So if that's not happening, I'm going to use a terminology the brother said one time. He said, God said it pleased him by the foolishness of preaching to save men. Not foolish preaching.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. So all that person doing is exciting and thrilling people. They're feeding the beast.
Amen.
Feeding the beast. That's it. And got them all thrilled up in the flesh and they can't pursue and recover all because they're not empowered to.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. But never God's will. I said never.
Yeah.
It was never God's will for the body of Christ to be saved.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Moses said to the first body,
hallelujah.
Because they were baptized under Christ in the Red Sea. The first body, Moses said unto them, and you shall serve the Lord your God. And he will bless your bread and water. And do what?
Take sickness from the midst.
Take sickness away from the midst of them. That's what he said. So God said if we would serve him, he'll bless our food and our drink.
Glory.
And sickness would not be a common thing among us.
Thank you, Lord.
I don't know if y'all watch or pay attention, but churches are full of sickly people.
Yeah.
Even when the scripture said that they're sick among them, let them call the elders of the church. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And they are anointed them with oil and praying over them, the prayer of faith shall save the sick, and the Lord shall raise them up. Still, the church is full of sick people. Then God said in Exodus 15 and 26, you diligently hearken unto the voice of the Lord your God. Do that which is right in his sight. Keep his commandments, walk in his statutes and judgment. He'll suffer none of the diseases which he brought upon the Egyptians. I'm going to use the term like the wicked.
Amen. Amen.
To come upon you. For he is the Lord that healed you.
Amen.
Amen.
Lord.
Then he said, 1 Peter 2 and 24.
Mm-hmm. He is almost there.
There are sicknesses mm-hmm. in his own body
Lord.
Upon the tree, that we being dead to sin, do mm-hmm. live unto righteousness, by whose stripes
word.
Ye were healed. Mm-hmm. Hello. So sickness should not be coming.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
Amen.
So what is going on, Pastor? Mm-hmm. It's an individual thing. Matthew 9:29 said, according to your faith,
Lord,
it's going to be done unto you. When that fifth child of Mark, when Jesus was talking about the issue of blood, he said, a daughter, go in peace. Thy faith have made thee whole. Her faith made her whole. Mm-hmm. So the problem has never been that the promise is not there. The problem has always been the inability or the lack of the desire will to what? To apply the appropriated in an individual life because they didn't have the hunger or the thirst to pursue God. Amen. So what are you talking about, Pastor? Well, we started out, the head topic is, you know, watch and pray. And you may be accounted worthy, being accounted worthy. That's the head topic, being accounted worthy. So now we're talking about why a lot of people, listen, why a lot of people don't know why and don't understand, don't know what to do, and why I always question.
Yeah.
Because they think that if it's God's will, it just will happen. No, that's not how it works.
Thank you.
According to your faith.
Amen.
Whosoever will, let him come. Mm-hmm. Draw nigh to me, and I'll draw nigh to you. Not I'll draw nigh to you, then you draw nigh to me. That's what he's saying. Call upon me, and I'll answer you. That's what he's saying. Seek me with all your heart.
Thank you.
And I'll be found by you. Mm-hmm. Not you'll find me, then seek me with all your
heart. No.
No. Before you find and seek me with all your heart, then you'll find me. Mm-hmm. Am I right about it?
Crazy.
Am I right about it?
Amen.
A man ought always to pray and not to think. Amen. Why would he say that?
Thank you.
Not a man ought always pray and not to think if there was an opportunity to think.
Amen.
In other words, he's trying to explain to us that don't give up when you're praying because God will answer.
Amen.
Then he gives a parable about the woman that came to the unjust judge and wouldn't give him no rest.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Then he talked about the other neighbor that came because somebody came to his house. He's going to ask for somebody else, not himself. He goes to the neighbor, knock on the door, and he didn't want to answer the door. He kept knocking. He kept knocking. Then finally, the man got tired and got up. Went to see what he wanted. Amen. That's what they call an importune prayer.
Right.
But I call it a perpetual prayer where you just don't give up.
Amen.
But so many of us, you know, have been taught that, you know, if it be God's will, mm-hmm. well, the word of God said mm-hmm. is his will.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Put me in remembrance. Mm-hmm. All God promises in Jesus are yes, and so be it. So what does that mean? God wants to answer us. So if it's not happening, it's because we're not drawing nigh, we're not seeking, hello, we're not calling, hello, we're not knocking, hello.
Praise.
Amen. That's why it's not happening.
Lord.
But brother, God really wants me to have it, why it takes so hard to get it? Because there's a devil.
Wow.
Can I get a witness?
Mm-hmm.
There's a devil that don't want you to get it.
That's it.
The devil don't want you to have anything God promised you.
Mm-hmm.
Can I get another witness?
Amen.
So he's going to do everything in his power to distract you and keep you out of what God got for you because he don't want you to have it. Because he knows if you start getting your prayers answered, God start moving your life like you see the Bible say.
Amen.
The devil ain't got no more hope when trying to get you back.
Wow.
So his greatest ploy is to try to keep you distracted so that you don't focus because it says seek ye first.
Lord.
I think that's what Jesus said.
What he said?
Read what he said. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness.
Mm-hmm.
And what he said? And all these things will be added unto you. Mm-hmm. So So if you leave that first part out, that other part ain't gonna work. So the devil does everything in his power to keep you from, I can't see. To keep you from doing the first part by distracting you with pain and suffering, needs and whatever, bills and family and friends and all that kind of stuff. Forget all that. What does it matter in the presence of the Lord?
Glory. Amen. Hallelujah.
I'm gonna give a truer thing right quick. If you can bring all that into the presence of God,
thank you, Lord Jesus.
If you can bring all that into the presence of God, do you know all that would become incident? The pain, the bills, the children, the friends don't want to treat you right, the husband and wife not treat you right. You bring all that into the presence of God, you know what will happen? All this will fade away. Yes. None of that will matter.
Hallelujah.
But the reason why it's so got our attention so strong now, because we don't live in the presence.
Thank you.
Amen. You got to
remember. Thank you.
Amen. Once you abide in God's presence, all Hallelujah. That stuff fades away.
Amen.
Become insignificant.
Jesus.
And I've learned this about it. If you stay in His presence enough, all that stuff will line up after a while.
That's right.
Amen.
And quit getting out of order and start getting in order.
What? Glory!
Because most folks don't know this, that in God's presence, there's no disorder.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
There's no confusion.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Everything bows.
Glory! Thank you, Lord God.
Everything bows. So if we live in prayer, and what did He say? I never leave.
You.
Not for the sake. Lord, I'm with you.
Always.
Even under what?
End of the world.
So we can be in His presence always.
That's right.
But we don't strive to do what it takes to be there.
Mm-hmm.
Because we were told we come in the presence, we come to the church. No, thank God you come to corporate presence. That's a corporate presence. That's different. But you can have the body presence in the day.
Hey. Woo! Glory.
24/7, 365 days a year.
Yes.
He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you.
He would be home with
that. I'll be with you forever.
Amen.
Jesus said, I pray the Father give another comfort that will abide with you
forever.
So the comfort is the anointing, the Holy Ghost. And then the scripture says, the Lord is that spirit.
Mm.
And where the spirit of the Lord is, there's liberty.
That's right.
How can you, if you got the presence of God, how can the devil be cutting up in that presence?
Amen.
The anointing removes the burden.
Amen.
Jesus talks about casting out demons. He said, if I cast devils out by Beelzebub, how shall your children cast them out?
Jesus.
Except by the Spirit of God, the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So it is the Holy Ghost that drives the devil out.
Mm. Thank you.
Hello, somebody.
Woo, glory.
Jesus cast them out by the Spirit of God. They try to say you're casting out Beelzebub. But God was used by His Spirit, the anointing on Christ's life, drove the devil away. So if you're in the presence of God, that's the Holy Ghost.
Well,
where's the devil?
You can't get around. You can't be there.
It ain't happening, Captain.
The greater one is there.
Because the Holy Ghost is the greater one.
Thank you.
And when He's on the scene, the devil's somewhere high.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You can't be there.
So those are the situations we call mega problems that the devil try to distract us with. Get them into the presence of God and they will dissipate.
That's right.
There'll cease to be such a, you know, a lot of times the reason why it looks like a mountain when it's really a molehill, because where you're looking from.
Change your location.
Hello, somebody.
Thank you.
Glory. In the place of our sanctuary in the beginning. Today you got saved.
Thank you.
Second chapter of Ephesians.
That's it.
5th and 6th verse. We were dead in trespasses and sin, yet made us alive together with Christ and the Savior, and have raised us up together with Him and seated us in the heavenlies in Him.
Lord.
So the place is your beginning. Hello, somebody. Hello, somebody. The place that you started out with was a glorious high throne. That was my, in a heavenly sanctuary.
Thank you, Jesus.
You need to believe that. Embrace that. Amen.
Thank you.
And the devil, you'll be looking down at it instead of looking up at it. And that mountain will no longer be a mountain, but become a holy.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
And just depending on what location you're looking at it from.
Right.
So your problem will cease to be a problem depending on where you're looking from.
That's right. Thank you.
So if you're still looking at it as being a problem, then it's going to be a problem.
Thank you.
But if you look from heaven down at it as being something that's already been resolved through the life, death, burial, resurrection, and ascension of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, it becomes nothing.
Hallelujah.
What did you just say, Pastor? I think you missed that one. No, I didn't miss that one. You missed it. Jesus cried from the cross, it is finished.
Amen.
All God promises in Jesus are what?
Yes.
Yes. And so be it. Yea and amen. You understand what that means? That everything that we could ever need, everything that we could ever want, everything that we need God to do for us was done when Christ said it was finished on Calvary. The moment you said, I accept Jesus, the moment you bow to you, the Lordship of Jesus Christ, and accept him as your personal Savior, all of a sudden, you transferred from earth to glory.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah.
And all of a sudden, you ascended.
Changed position.
You change positions.
Woo! How do you see yourself?
Now, all your problems now have been resolved.
Mm.
Can you see it that way? If you're in Christ, yes, you can. If you're not in Christ, no, you can. Because it don't belong to you. You got to bow your knee to the Lordship of Jesus Christ and receive him into your heart and begin to follow him, then it belongs to you. Are you following what I'm saying?
Thank you, Lord.
So the enemy does not want you to focus on that. Looking. 12th chapter of the book of Hebrews. Where that second verse? Looking unto Jesus. Somebody say looking unto Jesus. Looking unto Jesus. Peter looked out there, got scared with the rest of the boys, thinking they're about to die. Because that's what they say when sailors see an apparition on the ocean. That means he's getting ready to die. So they all were scared because they thought they saw a ghost. And Jesus' words were, fear not,
no.
It's only I.
Like,
just like, fear not, it's only you. Like we supposed to know? Yeah, because I am who I am. Strolling across the water like he was on a Sunday stroll through the park. Are y'all following what I'm
Thank
saying?
You, Lord.
They struggling, wrestling against the waves. The waves, every distraction in the world to make them doubt was there. That God was on their side.
Amen.
Boat filling up with water. They struggling just to get across the ocean, get across the sea. And here comes Jesus strolling, so they knew they were finna die. But they thought it was ghosts. And they got afraid. Hello, somebody.
That's it.
So I always say, don't let fear rip you off. Because faith and fear cannot exist in the same
Amen.
Spirit.
Amen.
If you let fear in your heart, faith will leave.
That's it.
Right. Keep the fear out.
Amen.
Amen. Be not afraid.
Amen. Only. Thank you.
Only believe. But Jesus said, don't be afraid of judgment.
Thank you, Lord.
Like he's strolling through the park on a Sunday evening. And Peter said, the only one, y'all get this now, the only one of overcame his fear enough, say, Lord, if it be thou, if it be you, Lord, did God say? But Pastor Claus here to tell you, he did say.
He did say.
So be not afraid. So he said, Master, if it be thou, bid me come. Jesus said, in the English language, a four-letter word, come.
Amen.
Peter slipped over the side of that boat on this. Now remember, the water was boisterous. The waves were high, beating into the ship, and they were fearing for their life.
Glory.
The wind never stopped. The waves never stopped. All this was still going on when Jesus was strolling across the sea. Like it was on a Sunday afternoon walk through the park.
That's it.
But Peter had enough faith in Christ to say, if it's you, Master, if it's really you, then you can help me do it. I don't know how you're still sitting there. If you truly believe that you have Jesus in your life, you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. I'm going to leave that alone because I can go right there too. So Peter slipped over and he started walking on the wall. The water was still wavering. Wind waved beating against the ship, probably with Peter's head. The wind blowing strong. Hello, somebody. Mm-hmm. Jesus still strolling like it ain't nothing. Peter now walking like it ain't nothing. But all of a sudden, one of them big wings slapped him. The wind hit him. Right? Mm-hmm. Peter got afraid. Mm-hmm. And began to sing. And I like to say, wherefore did thou doubt? When did he doubt? When he took his eyes off of Jesus and put them back on the circumstances. Looking unto Jesus,
Lord,
the author and the finisher. Hear me say it Sunday. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. He is the initiator and the perfecter of it. So if you want what you, if you believe this is the word of God, you believe that all these promises are yours, you cannot get to the fulfillment of it by looking at the circumstances. Mm-hmm. You got to keep Jesus, the word of God, in front of you. Mm-hmm. My son, attend to my word. Incline your ears unto my saying. Let them not depart from before your eyes.
Hallelujah.
This book of the law shall not depart
from before your eyes.
But you shall meditate in it
day
and night, that you may observe to do. God said that to Joshua, then Solomon turned around and picked it up and said, my son, don't let that word depart from before your eyes. Mm-hmm. So how are we going to possess? How are we going to get these promises? How are they going to manifest in our life? They're already yours. Mm-hmm. But you can keep your eyes on the thing that's saying they're not yours. Mm-hmm. The symptoms, the circumstances, the lying distraction, instead of focusing on what God said, they are yours. You're an heir of God and joint heir of Christ, so they what? Yours. Mm-hmm. Can I get an amen? Mm-hmm. And Jesus is at the right hand of the Father, interceding, make an intercession for you right now. The book calls him our mediator. The book calls him our advocate. Hello, somebody. Yes. Mm. Not only did he the one that initiated the will.
Thank you.
But now he mediated the will.
Hallelujah.
So when I'm standing there saying what the Lord said in the face of the circumstances, Jesus is standing there before the Father saying, it's theirs. Rome belongs to him. That one man.
Glory to God.
That one hour of God that belongs to him. Daddy, that day. Y'all ain't get it. Y'all ain't get it.
Thank you, Lord.
You get it one day. Keep focused. Stay focused. Stay focused. You get it. So while I'm on the earth saying what God said about me, Jesus in heaven saying what God said.
Thank you. My mediator.
Y'all get it?
Lord.
As I'm decreeing and declaring it on earth, Jesus decreeing and
declaring
it.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Look at them and say, while I'm decreeing and declaring the promises of God in my life on earth, Jesus in heaven is decreeing and declaring the promise of God from heaven.
From heaven.
Lord. So every time I say by Jesus' stripes I'm healed in heaven, they say, you healed. Every time I say God supplies all my needs according to riches and glory in heaven, they say, your needs are met. Amen. Every time an enemy comes out against me, and I say, "Do my enemy coming out against me like a flood," the Holy Ghost is sort of standing against them from heaven. Heaven said, "Your enemies are your footstool."
Hallelujah! Hey, cool.
Are you following what I'm saying?
Yeah.
See, we think that heaven is gonna say other than what the script said. No, it's God's word. It's eternally extended. The Bible said it's forever settled in heaven.
Thank you.
Forever settled in heaven. You get what I'm saying?
Hell.
So I'm saying it on earth. Heaven saying it.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey.
Your hand you got away from.
Lord.
I had to work that out right quick, but I had a follow-up. So on earth, I'm decreeing and declaring what God has said, but God has already established what I'm saying throughout all creation. Now I'm gonna mess everybody up in here. I'm gonna mess you up. I want you to go to Colossians 1st, chapter 1st, and I'm gonna mess you up right now. We're talking about
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Putting God in remembrance of what he said, that you might possess what he said. Amen. Look at this now. Watch this. Don't go there yet. Watch this. In the beginning was the word. It's not in this chapter now. That's St. John 1:1 I'm quoting. Right. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. Hebrews 1:3, 1st chapter, 3rd verse said, God upholds all things. I'm not talking about either. God is now spoken to us in old times, spoken to men through angels. But now in these sons, the time spoke to us by his son. who's expressing into the person of the Holy Ghost, will hold all things by the word of his power. God upholds all things by the word of his power. So God's power is expressed in the word. In the beginning was the word, and the word with God, and the word was God. God's power is expressed in the word. He upholds all things by the what? The word
of his power.
God's power.
Hallelujah.
God's power. God's power is expressed in the word. Are you getting?
Yeah.
The 11th chapter, the 3rd verse says, we understand by faith that the world was framed by the word of God. Are you getting it here? Are you getting it?
Thank
David
you.
Said, forever, Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. Is that about it?
Yeah.
Now watch them. I read something to you out of the 1st chapter of Colossians, 15 verses. With the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature, that's talking about Jesus, but by him, the Logos, the Word, St. John 1:1, St. John 1:14, the Word made flesh and dwelt among us. But by him were all things created. All things. Heavenly things.
All
earthly thing,
all
spiritual thing,
all
natural thing,
all
thing, all thing,
all
thing, all thing,
all
thing were created by the word of God.
Thank you, Lord.
What part did y'all didn't get? What part did you didn't get? That are in heaven, that are in earth, all things, all things,
yes, Lord,
all things,
all
in heaven and in earth. Why is it visible and invisible? Visible and invisible. What are you talking about? What you can see and what you can't see. What you can see and what you can't see. But made by the word of God. Are you getting it yet? Somebody say all things.
All
things.
All things.
Visible. Invisible. Whether you can see it or can't see it.
All.
If you ain't lost it yet, you'll never get this.
Jesus.
Whether they be thrones, or dominions, or principalities, or powers.
Yes.
You talking about the devil got power, you talking about demons. You talking about a gun, you talking about a knife, you talking about a bomb, you talking about... Visible or invisible?
Invisible.
You talking about a president, you talking about a prime minister, you talking about a dictator, you talking about a gang, you talking about whether it be throne, a dominion, a principality, a power, all things. All things.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody say all things.
All
things. All things.
All.
Somebody say all things.
All.
All things.
All.
What things?
All
things.
Yes, Lord. Thank you. Jesus, glory to God.
All things are created by him,
him.
Oh. And for
him.
Are you here? What things?
All
things. Watch this. And he is before all things. Of course he is, because he's going to create.
That's right.
Now this is what messed me up, and this is one that you need to get in a deep part of your knowing.
Mm-hmm.
And by him,
mm-hmm.
all things consist. Okay. Now I'm going to change that word just a little bit, and it might mess a whole lot of theologians up, but they call they're not in the spirit.
Well.
And by him all things exist.
Yes. Thank you. Exactly. Glory to God.
Without him, nothing exists.
That's right.
But by him, all things exist. Woo! We understand that the heavens were framed by the word of God.
Amen.
We understand that he upholds all things by the word of his power.
Mm.
it would not even exist.
Mm-hmm.
Whether it be thrones, whether it be dominions, whether it be principalities, whether it be powers, whether it be things visible or invisible, whether it be heavenly things or earthly things, they only exist, she quotes it. Woo! Amen. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
By the word of God.
Amen.
Are you hearing me?
Glory to God.
So when we go to God and say what he said in the word of God.
Yes, Lord.
Heaven can't cry nothing back but the word of God.
Word of God.
So when we say what God says.
Yes, Lord. Thanks.
Because everything is of hell. Everything consists. Everything exists because of the word of God. That means the word is at the center of everything we see.
Well.
Yeah.
So when we start talking the word, what are we speaking to? We're speaking to the very life nature of the thing that we're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
The thing that gives its existence, that's what we're talking
about. That's what we're talking about.
Mm.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus. Let me ask you, God, wait a minute. That was so powerful, it shut my lips. I couldn't say nothing. But nothing come out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So when I stand before God and I put him in remembrance, I'm not really saying something that's out of the way. I'm not being disrespectful.
No.
I'm just saying what the heavens are saying.
That's right.
I'm repeating what everything around me is created and made out of. All I'm decreeing and declaring is what it's supposed to be.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
I am supposed to be healthy. I am supposed to be strong.
Yes.
I am supposed to be rich. I am supposed to be, y'all hear me?
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
Jesus.
So I'm not presumptuous. I'm presumptuous. I'm not saying something that's blasphemous. I'm saying what God, I'm just daring to agree with God.
Amen.
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 And that's all God waiting for, to hear his voice in the earth.
That's right.
Yeah.
Woo. Someone. Yeah.
That's what he's running all throughout the whole earth trying to find somebody that really believes what Pastor Carlton said tonight. And they're going to start saying before heaven and the earth that
woo!
This is just say the Lord.
Thank you.
Amen.
Uh-huh.
Ain't no storms in the Bible that God created.
No.
God never sent no storm. The
no.
devil brought the storm.
Yeah.
Right.
So when you stand before a storm that's trying to start up your neighborhood and you say, hold on, peace be still.
Hallelujah.
It's yeah. supposed to be peace.
Hallelujah.
Everything's supposed to be in order, not chaotic.
Thank
so when you command peace be still, heaven looks down and says, peace be still.
Order.
Hey.
And the very thing in that stone that's given its existence is the word of God. So you are now saying to that word in that storm, peace.
Thank you.
Everything has to go back in order. Are y'all hearing what I'm saying?
Amen.
So when we put God in remembrance, all we're saying is what God said mm-hmm. on this earth.
Mm-hmm.
And when we say it on this earth, God says it from heaven.
Mm-hmm.
Heaven and earth not in line, come in line with each other.
Mm-hmm.
God gave you to me.
Mm-hmm.
So when you get in line with heaven, you know why the earth is in the shape of things? Because man got out of line with God.
Exactly.
When you get back in line with God, earth has to obey you.
Lord,
are you hearing what I'm saying?
Yeah.
When this thing really gets you in your Lord, it's going to change your life forever.
Mm-hmm.
When man get back in line with God, or got out of line with him, had to get back in line with him.
Yeah.
The only reason why it disobeys man is because man is not obeying God.
Thank you.
So once we learn to stand on that word and the way we carry ourselves and in what we say, watch out. You'll become such a powerful force on the earth. And the enemy can try, but it won't work. Because even when I found out, he don't have no power.
Right.
He had to borrow it.
Mm-hmm. I'm glad to get it to him.
Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
He has to borrow power from someone.
Mm-hmm.
So don't give him none of yours.
Hallelujah.
He don't have any authority. So he has to borrow yours.
Amen.
Don't give it to him.
Amen.
How did I get through fear?
Mm-hmm.
Through ignorance?
Mm-hmm.
My people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
Get in that word of God, let that word of God get in you, and the enemy will have no place in your life. He'll come, but he won't find nothing. Every head bowed. Father, we thank you. Father, we praise you. Father, we honor you. I enjoy you. I thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Blessings that you've taught me over the years. I thank you for empowering me to give it to other people, and it's empowering them that they might become an example and give it to someone else. Father, we give you the glory that you're moving in your children.
Yes, Lord.
And through your children.
Thank you, Lord.
In this house, throughout this city, throughout this county, throughout this state, and this nation, that your children are rising up, lining their lives up with you, and saying and decreeing what you say. That the enemy will not proceed, will not prosper, that everything he set out to do is falling apart. Mm-hmm. We call confusion.
Yes, Lord.
Into his camp.
Thank you, Jesus.
May they turn on each other, mm-hmm. even as I believe it's the Sennacherib's people. Mm-hmm. May they turn on each other
yes.
and begin to slay one another. So they want, I call my name, say to that one shot.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Spring confusion to their camp. In the mighty name of Yeshua. And Lord God, undergird your children. Show them that thou art God. In your precious name I pray. Everyone say amen,
amen.
And amen again. Amen. Just remember, it is collective, but it's individual.
It's individual.
Hello? You got to come to Christ. Once you come to Christ, then you become connected because he baptized you into his body.
Amen.
But while you're still outside the body, it's individual. So you need to believe and come to the Lord Lordship of Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. And you just simply say, Lord Jesus, I believe that you died for me. Let God the Father raise you from the dead for me. And I have sinned and I bow my knees to your Lordship. Forgive me. And save me. And make me your child. Just that simple. And the Lord will come into your life and transform you and change you inside out. Don't I tell people, don't look for no signs and no wonders. Mm-hmm. Just know God heard you. Mm-hmm. Get your Bible. Start reading the New Testament. Learn everything that God did for you through Christ Jesus. Memorize it, hide it in your heart, and start saying it. Mm-hmm. Don't speak against God.
Amen.
People agreeing with the devil. Why don't you agree with the devil?
Mm-hmm.
Don't agree with the devil, disagree with the devil.
Amen.
And don't beg that, well, how do you say the thing about right? We can agree to disagree.
Yeah.
No, I ain't agreeing to disagree with no devil. The devil is the devil. I'm not trying to get along with the devil. I'm not trying to coexist with the devil. My word told me that my master, my Lord, my king told me to cast him out. He said, nobody coexists with him. He ain't trying to coexist with him. Well, don't rock the boat.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to rock it.
Thank you.
And next thing, I'm going to turn it over to get the devil out.
Hallelujah.
Then we're going to figure out how to get it back up right here.
Get the
devil out of the capsize, and they're going to be capsized. Amen.
Thank you.
And then after destroying him, it's time for the devil to get out your business.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. God bless you. Appreciate every one of you. Thank God for you. I'm going to go my way, YouTube and Facebook. Thank God for your appreciation. Hope you got something out of that lesson. Mm-hmm. Meditate on it. Begin to find out what God said about you. We got promises to book you out. Let's see if I got one up on the here. Yeah, I got one. We got a book called The Promise Book. And for a dollar donation, we'll send it to you. Mm-hmm. If you don't have a dollar, just write and we'll send it to you. That dollar will just help put a package in and send it to you. Mm-hmm. That ain't gonna pay for this. This book costs $1.99 years ago. If you don't believe, wait till you get one, look on the back of it and you see how much it costs. But they ain't paying for the book, you're just paying for the handling and shipping.
Amen.
So if you want one, there's a promise book. Don't have all the promises, but you got a lot. And you need to start memorizing these promises and hiding them in your heart and saying what God says about you. And I'll be glad to send it to you for a dollar donation. If you don't want, don't, if you don't have it, I understand. It's right from, I'll send it to you anyway. Amen. God bless you, every smile, and thank God for each day when you donated and kept the ministry going strong. We do support other ministries that feed the home, clothing, the naked shelter, and the homeless, and care for all the widows. Amen. All across this nation and the world. I am so grateful that God gave me that vision. And even though we're not able to do it on our own, we are working with other people that do it.
Amen.
We thank God for it. What you send here, we support others. May God bless you and increase you for your giving. If you'd like to send in this week, again, the Cash App is $LOBE3921. If you'd like to send it by mail, the address is Post Office Box 769, Dillon, South Carolina, 39536. And again, if you want to use PayPal, and I'll provide you PayPal a lot of times, called PayPal charges for it. It's probably for PayPal, me. It's PayPal, period, me. / Love and Deliverance. Thank you, lady. So if you got a PayPal account, that's where you do it. PayPal, period, me. / Love and Deliverance. And that'll put it right in our account. If you don't have a PayPal account, you can go to PayPal, love, period, and, period, deliverance at gmail.com, and that'll work. Mm-hmm. But we prefer the other way. Mail it in, PO Box 769, Dillon, South Carolina, 29536, or the Cash App. We thank you for everything you've done. You'll reap 30, 60, and 100 fold. I was talking to the Lord the other day, and such an overwhelming presence came on me, saints. And I knew beyond a shadow of a doubt, because he was reminding me that he had blessed me to bless people. So I don't care what you're going through, I don't care what struggle you're going through. When you plant seed in good soil, it's going to come up. Mm-hmm. When you plant seed in the soil where God has poured out his blessing and anointing upon it, miraculous things happen. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
But listen, this is the key. And I said this the other day, I'm glad people got it. You cannot allow offense to rise in your heart against a brother or sister in the Lord and that work for you. You cut yourself off from the divine hand, who I call the Holy Ghost. Mm-hmm. And he won't be able to move miraculously for you like that. Mm-hmm. But when you keep that slate clean, when you come up on the smile of the anointed to bless people, that word will come fast. Amen.
Man.
So you'll reap 30, 60, and 100 fold. And you can stand like Sister Taylor was saying Sunday, in that spot where God spoke to you, and put him in remembrance.
Mm-hmm.
And I promise you, it will happen.
Amen.
It will manifest. God bless you. Mark with him. We'll see you Sunday. Amen. I won't be speaking. We got a blessed speaker. One of my daughters will be speaking on the Women's Day program. If you live anywhere near Dillon, South Carolina, you're invited to come out. We do our, you know, we do the spacing and the mask and the sanitizing. So if you'd like to come out, it's 508 South 9th Avenue, Dillon, South Carolina. We're going to look for an awesome time and Women's Day program Sunday at 12 noon. God bless you. Lord willing, see you then.